be strong.
Hello everybody, welcome back to Jonathan Tries. Today we are going to be trying four Asian snacks that my friend Walter got us from San Francisco. This one I just got from the pantry, but yeah. Alright, what should we start with?
I think we should start with the Haw Flakes.
Okay, so these are Haw Flakes. A lot of you might know what this is, but they're little flakes of candy based off of the fruit called Hawthorn.
Mm-hmm.
This grows in China, and it's, it might be good. It might be, it smells like dried cranberries.
Oh wow, they're kind of, it's tiny. Like a little disc. It looks like a sausage, kind of.
Yeah. All right, 3, 2, 1. It kind of just tastes like dried papaya.
Yeah. Yeah. Tastes like...
It tastes like dried fruit.
It tastes like craisins, kind of.
Yeah. I don't know. It's kind of weird.
Yeah.
Like, somebody would make a candy that tastes like... This is really weird.
Yeah.
It's like, the texture's like, almost like crumbling and like powdery. Have you ever gotten like one of those dig kits where you had to like look like,
smash through
sand and find like a gem or something?
Yeah.
The texture of this is how I imagine the sand to taste like.
Yeah, here, I'll do a little break. Bang.
Yes. Hold on. Break three at a time.
Mm-hmm. They're very crumbly.
Mm-hmm.
I would probably give it like...
6?
Yeah, average 6.
Mm-hmm. Alright.
Alright, next we have the Botan Rice Candy.
It comes with a free children sticker. We thought we would present that. Mine looks like a rocking horse. all right, let's try this. What's it taste like? I have no idea. It's double wrapped. It's kind of
red. It looks like taffy almost.
Don't eat it. It's like it's the second layer of wrappers is sticking to it.
Yeah.
Like I get that they put like powdered sugar and stuff on it to stop it, but I wonder if you can eat this second wrap. It would be good if you could.
Yeah.
It has like a taffy like consistency. I can pull it very easily. And when I pull it, it also helps get off the wrapper.
Wow.
It's really weird. It's like, there's like a shell on the outside and it's clear on the inside. Like a jelly bean or a Mike and Ike.
Alright, I'm gonna try it.
Alright, let's try. 3, 2, 1. That's really good.
Mm-hmm.
Alright. It tastes like a Mike and Ike. If a Mike and Ike was grapefruit flavored.
Yeah. Alright, it kind of tastes like pink lemonade, except not sour.
Mm-hmm. It tastes kind of citrusy. And then it starts to taste like a hardware store.
Mm-hmm. Not bad.
It tastes like soap, but without the bitterness.
Yeah. I would give it like a 7.
Yeah, 7.5.
It was better than the Haw Flakes, but
yeah. Mm-hmm.
Still just not really all that. Alright.
Alright. You going for another one?
Yeah. If they weren't wrapped so badly, I would have given it a higher rating.
Why put the second wrap on? There's no point. I hear Byron. I hereby vote to do a review of the second wrapper on all candies that have a second wrapper. Oh gosh. Oh gosh, no. Okay, you know what?
I'm done.
I'm had it with this. I'm eating the plastic.
I'm going down. My rating's gone down to a 4.
What?
The taste isn't worth the unwrapping. But next week.
No, the funny part is, you can eat the plastic. It'll dissolve in your mouth.
Never mind.
It dissolves in your mouth, right?
Mm-hmm.
Never mind, it actually tastes kind of nice.
Yeah.
Alright. My rating's back to 7. Alright, next we have Yam Yam. It's very similar to Nutella Co. with, if you guys have heard of that. But there are these little sticks. This one's, okay, so it has an animal name on them. And it has the, I guess, world record in the animal kingdom. Mine is a duck, and it says quack, quack on it.
Mine is a fox, and it says cunning and sly, if you can see that.
True. Alright, so we're gonna dip it in this Nutella-like sauce. And they're about two bites, so like, there's no need to double dip, just use the other side. Ah. It's really good.
Mmm.
I like it better than the Nutella gum. I call stag you beetle.
The breadsticks are really good.
Mm-hmm. They're like,
whoa,
well made. I get an extra. But, mad ripoffs here. We don't get the whole side of Nutella.
Yeah, there's not enough chocolate for all the breadsticks.
Mm-hmm.
That is very good, though.
Very good. But we don't want to run out of time, so we're going to go on to the Choco Pie. It's boba flavored. It's black sugar milk tea flavored. And I already kind of imagine how this is going to taste. So, you want to open it?
Sure.
Oh, no. It's a little like dented from shipping, but.
Whoa.
That's the inside.
Looks like a s'more, kinda.
Yeah, cause, yeah. All right, 3, 2, 1. It's just like a normal one. I mean, it's gonna taste like that until I get to this part here. Yeah, just like boba.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know your personal boba order, so I'm just gonna say it tastes like brown sugar milk tea. I guess black sugar milk tea.
It tastes like graham crackers a little bit.
Yeah, it does. It really does. And it has marshmallow in it. So it's literally a s'more, but inverted.
Yeah. I would give that probably an 8. Mm-hmm. That's a solid one.
8.5. I mean, these rice candies are really good.
Yeah.
Screw the second wrapper. It actually dissolves in your mouth.
Yeah.
I taste no wrapper. And I actually had the whole wrapper on. Like,
oh my gosh.
It does?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that's awesome. Right. Good job for making biodegradable wrappers to not hurt the environment and also not hurt our throats. These yin yans are really good though. I like the animal records on them. Good.
Yeah.
They're really good. If we had to recommend one to the watch, who would you?
Either the Hall Flakes or the rice candy.
Yeah.
Because there's a lot of them.
Mm-hmm. Well, I think I would do the rice candies or the yin yin.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, really, I recommend all of them to you because they're all, like, delicious.
Yeah.
But yin yin, you need to add more chocolate dip to your product.
Mm-hmm.
But they're all really good. So, thank you for watching. We'll see you next time. Bye.